three, four.
Thank you so much. How's everybody doing tonight? Welcome. Welcome to the beautiful Riviera. Welcome to our theater tonight. My name is Ryan Joseph, and I'm from Nashville, Tennessee. It's an honor, true honor, to be with y'all tonight. I shouldn't have programmed that song first. A little out of breath. I got to be completely honest with y'all. I've been blessed to do so many wonderful things in my life and been so many places. I've never done a solo show on a cruise ship. So you guys, I'll remember you for the rest of my life. You're my first audience as a solo cruise show. And I got to tell you, I'm a lot less nervous now, because the most nervous I was about this entire show was walking out, playing the fiddle, and being able to, I don't know about y'all, but I'm not a drinker, but I haven't been able to walk a straight line in 2 days. And I know a few of you actually are the same way, because I was up in the lounge the other day, and a few of you I thought were coming over to be my friend, and come to find out it was just the ship that was bringing you over there. But but we're going to do a bunch of music for you tonight that is it encompasses a bunch of different styles. How many of you in here love country music? Okay, I have another question for you. How many of you don't like country music? It's okay. It's all right. It's all right. I love you just the same. What I love about music is it brings people together. I really have truly felt that and found that it's just such a vehicle to get people connected to each other. So no matter what type of music you enjoy, I hope we cover it tonight. I'm going to play a variety of instruments, as you can see. So I'm going to do the next one on the sax. I will say this is actually an old country tune. It's probably one of the oldest country tunes from one of the oldest country artists named Hank Williams. Y'all like Hank Williams? All right. Well, we're going to do a song called Hey Good Looking by Hank Williams, but we're going to do it like Jimmy Buffett did. So you can picture it as a country song, but if you don't like country music, you don't have to picture it that way. It's okay. And how many singers do we have in the crowd? All right. All right. Well, if you are inclined to sing along, I love company when I'm singing. So here we go, one called Hey Good Looking.
One, two, one, two.
Hey, good looking. What you got cooking?
I hear you.
How's about cooking something up with me? Hey, hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe we can find us a brand new recipe? I got a hot rod Ford and a $2 bill, and I know a spot right over the hill. There's soda pop and the dancing's free, so if you wanna have fun, come along with me. Hey, hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? About saving all your time for me. No more looking. I know I've been cooking, but how about keeping me steady company? I'm gonna throw my day book over the fence and buy me one for 5 or 10 cents. Keep it till it's covered with day. About cooking something up with me. How's about cooking, everybody? How's about? I hear you now. Yeah, how's about cooking something up with me? How many of you have heard Alan Jackson before? Live? I might have seen you out on the road. I've been blessed to be out with Alan for the last 7 years. You know, the first music that I ever purchased with my own money was Alan Jackson's. So I always tell, I do a lot of things for kids around the country, really. And kids of all ages, I always recommend chase your dreams. I was doing a little fiddle demonstration at the Country Music Hall of Fame, actually last year. And there was a lady, and again, I say kids of all ages. This lady was in her mid-70s, I think. And she just got inspired by the fiddle and retired from the Country Music Hall of Fame. You know, she has traveled over the last year. She bought an RV, and she's going to all kind of different fiddle camps now. So I say you live your dream. I don't care how old you are. It's anything is possible for sure. Anybody know, I'm going to ask you a question now. Anybody know the difference between a fiddle and a violin? Holler it out. I can't see you out there, but the way you play it. We have some smart people up here today. I'm telling you, it's surprising to me. But most people that I ask that question to think it's a completely different instrument. And my favorite answer that I ever got from that question was actually a little middle school young lady, just a beautiful little girl, so sweet. She raised her hand, and she said, well, my daddy said the difference is that when it's a fiddle, you can pour a beer on it. Was not expecting that. But didn't know what quite to say, but it really is the same instrument. It's just the music you play on it. So I started actually playing this instrument as a classical violin instrument. And classical music, I'm a teacher at heart, so I like to kind of share stuff with you as well. But it is passed down generation to generation by the printed page. So I'm doing so much moving up here that I don't think I'm going to go get the music now. But how many of you read sheet music in the crowd? Anybody? All right. Very good. Very good. I love being with musicians. Fiddle players, we learn by ear. I always say it's like learning a language, you know, and probably none of us remember actually learning how to talk. Well, it's kind of the same for me. I started playing the fiddle when I was 3 years old, and I listened to people play and copied them, and then eventually came up with my own sound. Well, I also play classical music, so I didn't want to let this evening go by without playing just a little clip of a classical Bach piece. And since you did so great singing along to Hey Good Looking, if you want to sing along to Bach too, that would actually be great. If you make any mistakes, he's not around anymore, so he's not going to care. But this is a little segment of a Bach sonata. So now we're going to get back into some of the music that is made in Nashville. And I want to do a song for you that I wrote. How many of you have children or grandchildren out there? Wonderful. How many of you, your children or your grandchildren, are your reason for living? It's your primary focus. Okay, maybe some of you know. That's all right. They're not here. We won't tell them. That's okay. Family's everything to me. And I started playing fiddle, like I've said, when I was 3 years old with my grandfather. And I always wanted to write a song kind of about my story. And not because my story is that interesting, but again, music and people and connecting with each other, I just think it's so important. And I hope that you maybe hear your story in mine in this song that I'm about to play for you. How many of you have kids or grandkids that play music? All right. Does anybody in here have a grandchild or kid that plays the violin? Who's? I hear a clap. Can I get some lights in the house, please? Would that be possible? Maybe not. No? No lights? Who is the person in the back there? Can you come on up? Can you all come on up? Somebody? Nobody? Somebody that has a child or grandchild. I'm going to give them my CD that I have out there today. Wonderful, wonderful. I hope that it inspires them. No worries, no worries. I I've been working on a CD for a couple years, and this song really actually inspired me to put it out because I just felt that the message was so strong. So it just came out, and I got it printed especially for this cruise, so we'll have it out there later after the show as well. But everything that I ever learned that is important to me really happened on my pappy's knee. So that's the title of this song. It's on my pappy's knee. And those of you who do have children and grandchildren, you never know what day you're going to affect them for the rest of their lives. So always be careful what you're doing.
Go ahead.
Called him Pappy, he was my mama's dad. A gentle soul and a humble man. He loved God and family, his fiddle and the song. And he'd play on and on. Well, I was just a baby, but I remember well the songs he'd sing and the stories that he'd tell. Then one day he showed me how to hold the bow, and I never did let it go. Family, faith, and music made the man I am today. The most important things in life to me, I learned sitting on my pappy's knee. His hand on top of mine, I feel like a king. As we pull the bow across the strings, your family would gather round just to hear us play. Pappy's knee became my stage. And when the show was over, fiddle set aside, he lifted me off his knee and set me down on mine. He'd say, thank you, Lord, for music and this family that we love, for fiddles and for all gifts from above. He taught me every melody and every note he played, to believe it more than I can see. Family, faith, and music made the man I am today. The most important things in life to me, I learned sitting on my pappy's knee. Left me his fiddle, now I'm proud to call it mine. And I still play our music out here on the road. And I still feel his hand on mine each time I touch the bow. He taught me every melody and every note he played, and to believe in more than I can see. And family, faith, and music made the man I am today. The most important things in life to me, well, I learned sitting on my pappy's knee. I learned them sitting on my pappy's knee.
Thank you so much. I have to say just one other thing, and I'm ready for some happy music for sure, but my father passed away when he was 52 years old, and he used to tell me, Ryan, do something you love. I can't wait to retire. And he had a heart attack. So that was really the reason that I moved to Nashville. My mom came with me, and as you can tell, I'm all about family. And Dottie is also part of our family, so it is quite the honor to be with you all today. And how about a big hand for this band, y'all? We never met each other until today, and it's just doing such a fabulous job. And they're all from Poland, and I'm kind of, I guess, indirectly from Poland. I'm 100% Polish, and as Dottie mentioned, I grew up in a family polka band, so I don't think we could go out of this room today without me playing you at least a little clip of a polka, and I'm from McKeesport, Pennsylvania, so why don't we just play the Pennsylvania polka?
All right.
Strike up the music, the band has begun. The Pennsylvania polka. Pick out your partner and join in the fun.
There you go.
The Pennsylvania polka. It started at Scranton, it's now number one. It's bound to entertain ya. Everybody has a mania to do the polka from Pennsylvania.
Here we are.
While they're dancing, everybody's cares are quickly gone. Sweet romancing. This goes on and on until the dawn. They're so carefree, gay with laughter, happy as can be. They stop to have a beer and the crowd begins to cheer. They kiss and then they start to dance again. Yeah. This goes on and on until the dawn. They're so carefree, gay with laughter, happy as can be. They stop to have a beer and the crowd begins to cheer. They kiss and then they start to dance again. Yeah!
I love to see people dance. That's great. That's why I love the fiddle. Going to do another song for you right now that kind of blends country music and pop music, rock music. How many of you like Michael Bublé? one of my favorite singers for sure. He has a wonderful song that a country artist by the name of Blake Shelton also did called Home. And I want to do that one for you right now. It has particular special meaning to me right now because I am newly engaged. So thank you. Thank you. Finally found the one. It was a long search, and people used to tell me, and I know I was here last night for the show, so I know. How many of you have been married for over 50 years? All right. Wonderful. Wonderful. I need to get some advice from you after the show, so you better come back there no matter what. But people used to tell me, you know, you just know. And I finally know. I wasn't believing them for a long time, but I do know that she is she's wonderful. But because she's at home now, it makes the road a little less attractive because when I'm with her, I feel like I'm at home. So we're going to do this song for you. Yeah, there you go. Aw, right on cue. So we're going to do the song Home for you. Hope you enjoy. Another summer day that's come and gone away in Paris and Rome, but I wanna go home. Maybe surrounded by a million people, I still feel all alone, but I wanna go home. I miss you, you know. I've been keeping all the letters that I wrote to you, each one a line or two. I'm fine, baby, how are you? I would send them, but I know that it's just not enough. My words were cold and flat, and you deserve more than that.
Another airplane, another sunny place. I'm lucky, I know, but I wanna go home. Oh, I miss you, you know.
Let me go home. I'm just too far from where you are. I wanna come home. Someone else's life. It's like I just stepped outside and everything was going right. And I know just why you could not come along with me. Well, this was not your dream, but you always believed in me.
Another winter day is coming, gone away, and even Paris and Rome, and I wanna go home. Oh, let me go home.
And I'm surrounded by a million people. I still feel alone, and I wanna go home. I miss you, you know. Let me go. Back home.
Thank you all so much. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Danica Ports. How about a round of applause for her? If you haven't guessed, that is my fiance. Yes, I am marrying up. I know that. I know I'm marrying up. She is not only the love of my life, but in my humble opinion, even if I didn't know her, she is my favorite singer. She's an incredible songwriter, an incredible artist in Nashville. You write songs, and Danica is one of the best of that and best at singing. So I've requested that she sing you one of her songs that mean the most to her and mean the most to me as well tonight. So Danica, take it away.
Thank you. How about Ryan Joseph? I might be biased, but he is the best. He is the best in town, so it's exciting to be able to be out and play together. But I wrote this song, actually. I've been really lucky. I've been in Nashville for 8 years as a singer-songwriter, and I just got back last month from my 7th overseas military tour performing for our troops. Yeah. Thank you. It's honestly, it's been the highlight of my career, and we have we've gone all over Europe and the Mediterranean and the Middle East, and it is just life-changing work, really work. I've got two brothers in the Air Force, so it kind of hits home on a personal level. And when I did my very first tour back in 2015, we were in Kuwait, and I met a young gentleman. He was like our point of contact for the day. And in the middle of our day, he had gotten a phone call from his wife back, I think in Nevada. And she was being rushed to the hospital to deliver their first child. And to watch this like 23-year-old go through this flood of emotions on the other side of the world while all this is happening back home really stuck with me and kind of really hit me hard. And I got back to the States and I knew I wanted to write a song for our military. And I couldn't stop thinking about that guy. And I was driving through Nashville and I saw this billboard that said, "Some superheroes really can fly." And instead of a picture of Superman, had a couple of our military personnel jumping out of an airplane, and I thought, well, if that's not the truth, if that's not 100% the truth. And so when people talk about the military, they can kind of, it's easy to lump them all together and just say, you know, thank you for your sacrifice, but I saw those sacrifices. And unless you have somebody who's in the thick of it, unless you've got a family member or someone really close to you that's in, it's really hard to see what those sacrifices are, but it's that time that they can't get back, right? It's that, you know, they're missing the births of their kids or weddings or funerals or just like anything. Their kids losing a tooth, their first musical, all those things. And that's what they can't get back. And so I've kind of made it my personal mission to tell their story out on the road. And I don't know if we could bring up the house lights. If we have any veterans here tonight and their spouses, because it takes a village when it comes to this, and there's someone holding down the fort back home. But if we have any veterans, if you wouldn't mind standing right now, because I want everyone to know who these people are that have sacrificed those moments, because it means the world to us and to me. So look around the room, because these are it. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much. This song is for you. This is called My Superhero.
Superhero, and he can fly.
to hug her cause she cries sometimes. Doesn't need a mask or cape to drive those bad guys away. I can't wait till I get to see him. When I grow up, I'm gonna be him. He's my superhero. He can fly 1,000 feet up in the sky. Sees the desert down below. And if he's scared, you'd never know. Jumps out of flames and says a prayer as he free falls through the air. He's my cat and my superhero. And he can fly.
Hey, check. Danica Ports, ladies and gentlemen. How about it? Okay.
What a beautiful song and a beautiful testimony. All right.
As Alan Jackson would say, I don't know how, I don't really have my watch on. I do have my watch on, but it's always 5 o'clock somewhere, right? So, any Jimmy Buffett fans in the crowd? All right. Alan Jackson and Jimmy Buffett say the same thing. It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
One, two, three. Sunny is hot and that old clock is moving slow. And so am I. The workday passes like molasses in wintertime. Hey, but it's July, getting paid by the hour and over by the minute. The boss just pushed me over the limit. Like to call him something, I think I'll just call it a day. And pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only half past 12, but I don't care. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. This lunch break is gonna take all afternoon and half the night. Tomorrow morning I know they'll be held to pay. Hey, but that's alright. Getting paid by the hour and over by the minute. The boss just pushed me over the limit. Like to call him something, I think I'll just call it a day. And pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only half past 12, but I don't care. Yeah, It's 5 o'clock somewhere. Myself in a cab and be back to work before two. At a moment like this, I can't help but wonder, what would Jimmy Buffett and Alan Jackson do with a drink package? Say, pour me something tall and strong, make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. Something tall and strong, make it a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. I don't care. It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Believe how quickly the time passes. Just have another song for you by Alan, and then we're going to have to call it a day. But I've been told, actually, before I came out here, I pulled an all-nighter before our 6 a.m. flight to Miami. I had the honor of being at Loretta Lynn's 87th birthday party at the Bridgestone Arena in Nashville. Got to play with Alan Jackson, George Strait, Garth Brooks, Trisha Yearwood, all these people. And I was telling Dottie that backstage, it was actually a three-hour show. Three-hour show. And she said, Ryan, that's really great, but I have a lot of activities planned for these people tomorrow morning, so they need to get some sleep. So I'm not going to keep you that long. But one of my favorite Alan Jackson songs, again, music and stories and connecting with people, are very important to me. So as you listen to the song, think about your life. I hope it brings back a lot of good memories. It's called Remember When.
So were you, time stood still. Love was all we knew. You were the first, so was I. Made love and then you cried. Remember when? Remember when? We vowed the vows and walked the walk, gave our heart, made the start, it was hard. We came together, fell apart, and broke each other's hearts. Remember when? Remember when? Old ones died and new were born. Life was changed, disassembled, rearranged. We came together, fell apart, and broke each other's hearts. Remember when? Music. We danced to week to week, brought back the love, we found trust, vowed we'd never give it up. Remember when? Remember when? 30 seems so old now looking back. It's just a stepping stone to where we are, where we've been. Said we'd do it all again. Remember when? Remember when? We said when we turn gray, when the children grow up and move away, we won't be sad, we'll be glad for all the life we've had. And we'll remember when. Remember when? Remember when?
Thank you all so much. Have you all had a good time? Wonderful. So have I. You know, I can't leave you all without playing this next tune. If you're a fiddle player in Nashville or anywhere in the world, this is one of the favorite tunes of the instrument. So how many Charlie Daniel fans do we got in the crowd? All right. Well, here we go with The Devil Went Down to Georgia. The devil went down to Georgia. He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he was way behind. He was willing to make a deal. When he came across that young man, saw him on fiddle and playing it hot. And the devil jumped on a hip stump, said, "Boy, let me tell you what. I bet you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take a dare, I'll just make a bet with you. Now you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but let's give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle with gold against your soul because I think I'm better than you." Boy said, "My name's Johnny, and it might be a sin, but I'm gonna take your bet and you're gonna regret, cause I'm the best that's ever been. Johnny, rising up your bow and play a fiddle hard. Tails broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals the cards. And if you win, you'll get that shiny fiddle made of gold. But if you lose, the devil debts your soul." Yeah. The devil opened up his case and he said, "I'll start this show." And fire flew from his fingertips as he rosined up his bow. Then he pulled his bow across the strings and it made an evil hiss. Band of demons joined right in and it sounded something like this. Johnny said, "You know, you're pretty good, old son, but you just fit right in that chair right there, and I'm going to show you how this stuff's done. Find a mind, run, boys, run. The devil's in the house of the rising sun. Picking in the bed, bam, picking out, though. Granted that your dog by no child, no." Well, that old devil bowed his head and he lost his mic because he knew he was been beat. He laid that golden fiddle right down the ground at Johnny's feet. Johnny said, devil, just come on back if you ever want to try it again. I done told you once, you son of a gun, I'm the best that's ever been. He played Fire in the Mountain, run, boys, run. The devil's an ass of the rising sun. Hanging in a red band, picking out though. Ready, does your dog mind, no child, no.
Gentlemen, Ryan Joseph. Bring it back up for a bow, ladies and gentlemen, Ryan Joseph. So glad you enjoyed the show, and Ryan and Danica will be out in the lobby if you want to stop by and say hello to them. So tonight, a little bit of ABBA, maybe after this, you're all charged up.